making three pronouncements in one sitting and throwing out a woman who has been living with you for many years, who has produced your children, and the baneful impact on the future of children, is more harsh or this belief harsh? Now, these are the people who are describing this, that the bill is harsh. It is those people who do not consider triple divorce a harsh thing. They have been defending triple divorce to the extent that they have brought out Muslim women onto the roads. You know, these are the women whom they do not allow even to enter a mosque to offer prayers there, but they have brought them out on the roads to protest against this bill. So to them, triple talaq is not an enormity. Any measure which is taken to check triple talaq, that is harsh. Whether it is, you have given three divorces, now court is asking you to pay some maintenance. How much? Only 47 rupees. They consider it very harsh and violation of Islam and Islamic law. And they start an agitation and force the government, the then government of Mr. Rajiv Gandhi, to bring a legislation to reverse the ratio in the Shah Bano case. In 1986, it was not 3 years. Just an amount of, the lower court had given only 47 or 52 rupees and Supreme Court had given 200 something. That was so harsh that they started such a, then it was not 3 years, it was only 250 rupees. That was very harsh to them. They started an agitation, they used violent language, intimidating language. They created reaction in the whole country. Every political analyst, every historian, be it Ramchand Guha or Bipin Chandra, read their books. They say that was the threshold. Shah Bano, the agitation which was started up by personal law board, that changed the political landscape of India. On 15th of January 1986, because this agitation, it was acquiring, I am not saying so, the Home Minister in Parliament, while defending this measure, the bill which government had brought, the Home Minister said, there is apprehension of breakdown of law and order, violence, so something was needed to be done. Home Minister had said. So they were, if you remember, inside Parliament, their supporters, they describe, they use contemptuous language for the judges of the Supreme. So ultimately government buckled under the pressure. And 15 January here at Sri Fort Auditorium, to a gathering, sympathetic gathering, Prime Minister announced that the Parliament session is going to start on 5th of February. And on the opening day, a bill, we have already reached an understanding with the Muslim Personal Law Board. And on the opening day, we will bring a legislation to reverse the ratio in the Shah Bano judgment. To reverse the judgment. Within a week, the situation became so explosive. I mean, till that time, till 15th of January, after the election, it was like honeymoon for Rajivji, political honeymoon. Then suddenly everything turned. Even Girilal Jain, who the traditional Mr. Arun Shori was criticizing, he has been critical in the past too. But Mr. Girilal Jain, look very, if you remember, he wrote very strong editorials against what the government was planning to do, and everybody turned against. What I, you know, I was in the government then. The IB and RAW, in their briefing to the Prime Minister, they informed him that the situation is becoming explosive. And I shall not go into details because I don't want to do name calling. But then decision was taken to do something which can divert attention of the non-Muslims from Shah Bano. And this unlocking of the gate at Ayodhya, nobody was talking about Ayodhya then. Unlocking was organized. A special team of DD, then private channels were not there. A special team of DD was dispatched to cover the whole thing. So, even before the parliament session started, on 15 January, you announced that you are going to reverse the judgment in the Shah Bano case. On 1st of, within a week, less than a week, the situation became so explosive that government was forced to do something. And on 1st of February, the lock was removed. And rest is history. Lock was not removed because an application was pending before the judge. Lock was removed because both the district magistrate and the superintendent of police appeared before the judge and they said that this locking of the gate is not part of the original suit, main suit case. This gate was locked at the instance of the administration in the interest of maintenance of peace and order. Now they said, without lock we can manage it. So who had given them instruction? Every year applications used to come. Every year in response to the application, the administration would say, they would file an affidavit, no, in the interest of the maintenance of peace and order, continuation of the lock is necessary. This time, they do not only send an affidavit. The district magistrate and the SSP personally appear in the court. The judge asks them in the open court, have you consulted the state, the government? They say, this is not the concern of the judge. We are the government on the spot and we can take care of this without lock. Even then the judge decided or he decided that he will give his order 3 or 4 days later, hoping that in case they are doing so on their own without informing the government, in during these 3-4 days the government will come to know of it. But then the court staff informs the judge that there is a television team outside to cover the event. Now television team was not possible unless the government had given the instructions. 4 days later, when he comes to the court to give his order, the staff again informs him that today more than 8 people are there from Doordarshan. 4 days back there were only 4. Then he was satisfied that they have consulted the government. And then he had no option. Any judge in his place, because the party at whose instance the gate was locked, now that party is saying that lock is not needed anymore. So rest is, I do not think there is any need for me to dwell on this subject. Rest is history. Shah Bano and opening of the gate, they happened within a span of 10-15 days. So who did it? I, more than the government, because government was being headed by a young prime minister who was very liberal, who was forward looking. But this Muslim leadership, who were demanding the reversal of the Shah Bano judgment, they were totally people without any vision, without any foresight, without any understanding. I hold them more responsible that you are pushing the Prime Minister into a situation where he will be forced to do something to manage the backlash. But they could not even perceive it. They could not even, because they are people, they are, you know, if I use the Muslim term, taqleed zada log hain. Taqleed means, taqleed, since, you know, all these madrasas, all these people, the clergy, they are all promoters of taqleed. And what is taqleed? Blind emulation of the ancestors. Taqleed means we shall not apply our own intelligence and reason. And that is why in these madrasas, all over the country, a student is not allowed to ask a question. Teacher has the book in his hand and all the students have the book in their hand. You can only read from the book, you cannot ask the question. And this is not the first time. Any movement which has ever been led by the clergy has met the same fate. Khilafat movement, what happened to that? In 1920s, Pakistan movement, it was ultimately what really turned the situation in favor of Muslim League was when Jamiatul Ulama was split into two parts, and one under the patronage of Maulana Ashraf Ali Thanvi, they became supporters of Muslim League and demand for partition. This is well documented that in UP people used to ask these mullahs the question that Pakistan will be carved out from Punjab, Bengal, UP will not be part of it. Why you want us to, I mean, how it will affect, this question was raised by people even in 1946. But Shabbir Ahmed Usmani's argument, which was given by later by every member of the the breakaway Jamiatul Ulama, was India was Darul Islam, Britishers changed it into Darul Harab. Now there is no possibility of India becoming again Darul Islam. So, if by making sacrifice, you can make at least, you succeed in making at least one part of India Darul Islam, you will be sacrificing, but it will be a great service for Islam. This was the argument of Shabbir Ahmed Usmani. So, mullahs are, not because they are less intelligent, not because they are less, you know, by training. Their training is that we have not to question anything. Taqleed is the religious and social norm among the Muslims since almost 750 years. In the 11th century, when the Ash'ari movement started, Ash'ari movement established the principle of taqleed. There is no need to study any subject except Quran and fiqh, Quran and jurisprudence, whereas Quran asks you repeatedly everywhere to study history, to study geography, to study geology, to study zoology, every subject Quran asks you to study. And they said there is no need to study any subject other than Quran and jurisprudence. Abul Hasan Ash'ari. And the movement became so strong that all the books of the Mu'tazila were burned down. And now all these schools are following, they are different sects among the Sunnis, but they all subscribe to Ash'ari. On taqleed, they are united. Do you think Congress leadership genuinely believed in what they did in 1986? I'm asking you. Men like Rajiv ji, do you think he would subscribe that a woman after divorce, if she is destitute, she should not be paid anything? If he was so enamored of this idea, he could have introduced it into Hindu law also. Why he did it? For political purposes. So if they do it for political purpose, it's okay. Others should not do it for political purpose. As far as I am concerned, I am not concerned whether what is the motive of the other person. I see the positive benefit flowing from this.